Thanks everyone for coming tonight. And I'm Candace Hopkins and I'm the Executive Director and Chief Curator of Forge Project. And I'm so grateful that Linda had us here tonight. So.
I want to welcome the Forge Project. It's such an amazing group of people and it's our honor to have them here, and we hope you enjoy all of these amazing performances and check them out. And also, please come to TSL more often. We're here.
Thanks, Linda. When we came to Linda with this idea that we do this collaboration, it was actually only a few weeks ago. And I have to say that I was just so inspired by this space. One, it's multi-purpose. I think it's for many, many audiences. But also, I was just really struck by the spirit of collaboration, which I think Forge shares. And we have a very different history because we've only been in operation for about a year, not since the 1970s like TSL.
Yes.
So we're grateful to be here. Forge Project was co-founded by Becky Goshman and Zach Foyer, and Zach's in the room, and some of you probably know Zach. He's probably too shy to wave. You're right there. yeah. I would be here. So Forge, if you don't know anything about us, we do a few things. We are an organization that's dedicated to Native futures, we like to say, and rethinking Native histories, which is a really important thing to do in these lands of the people of the waters that are never still, which is the Taghkanic people, or the Mohican people. And you all likely know that these are lands of great displacement, waves of displacement, you know, starting hundreds of years ago. And the Stockbridge-Munsee community now live in Wisconsin, but we are on their homelands, and I want to say that to honor them as well. So to tell you a little bit about Forge, Forge runs a fellowship. And Laura Ortman, the acclaimed musician, is one of the 2022 fellows at Forge, so we are so grateful to be here to honor her work. She is one of six fellows that we're hosting this year, and the fellows range in all in various backgrounds. They're doing incredible work in experimental music and visual art, beadwork, design, sustainable harvesting, decolonial governance, painting, basketry. So an entire wide range. And we think that, you know, one of the important things of Forge is to be a place where people can gather from many different backgrounds. So it's not necessarily just focused on visual art. We do a lot of events in Hudson. We worked with Mayor Kamal to declare May 5th the Awareness Day for the city of Hudson for an ongoing epidemic, which is murdered and missing Indigenous people. And there's more information on those stats. So we held a march here. We're really grateful for that collaboration. And we are located about 20 minutes away from Hudson, so we're not far. This is the largest, you know, community near where Forge is, on the kind of edge of Taghkanic and Ankrom. So we host a fellowship. We host a working farm with, in collaboration with Sky High Farms, that's dedicated to working with Black Indigenous farmers and all kinds of learners from all ages. And right now, they've planted a Three Sisters garden, so that's centered on corns, beans, and squash, all things that would have been grown here. And we have a lending art collection that's centered on the work of contemporary Native artists, so artists working now, working today. Part of that is, and I like to say that even our collection is activists in nature. So we try to get it out into the world because, you know, if you If you follow even the development of the narrative of the history of modern art, at a place like the Museum of Modern Art, for example, they predicate their own history on the borrowing of Native aesthetics, the liberal borrowing of the aesthetics, but yet, you know, the last Native group show at the Museum of Modern Art was in 1942. Mm-hmm. So there's a huge absence. So we're trying to, you know, work to not only correct that absence, but I think more importantly, ask the question why it exists. You know, why it exists when there's so many artists doing so much incredible work. So let's say that Forge is really dedicated to that incredible work. We run a lot of public programs, of which this is one. So we're just grateful to, for those of you who I haven't met, to have you here. And now it's my great honor to introduce a friend of mine, someone who continually inspires me, and that is Laura Ortman. Laura Ortman is White Mountain Apache. She's been living in New York City now, making her living as an experimental musician, which is not an easy thing to do, for the past 25 years. So hands together for that, I would say. Laura's not only a ray of light, she's a consummate collaborator. So one of the things that's kind of profound about Laura is almost anyone working in the field, I would say, at one point has collaborated with Laura. So she's collaborated with the late Tony Conrad, she's in John Zorn's new book, she collaborates a lot with with Raven Chacon, who's here in the audience as well, with Nanobah Becker, who was the director of My Soul Remainer, with Jock Soto, who's an acclaimed ballet dancer and choreographer, who's also in that video, and with many, many artists, visual artists as well, and not only scoring work, but you know, making your own compositions. And one thing that Laura says that she does, and we'll witness it tonight, is, you know, Laura's actually a trained artist, and you say that often, you know, you're working in sculpture, but now sound has become your sculpture. So I think that's what we're gonna witness tonight. So I won't keep rambling, but that's a small introduction to the incredible work of what Laura does, and really grateful to witness it tonight. So thank you.
Thank you. I just want to thank Forge so much for this gift and this time to be together with things and people and beauty and love and nature and everything that really, really matters. It's just day four. I'm already feeling magnificent. I live in New York a long time. I live alone, and it's totally trashed. It's great. My place is an amazing nest. But to have just surrounding people living with you under the same house on the same land, and home cooked food tastes better, and you sleep better, and you swim better. I just can't tell you what kind of support this means to me. I'm gonna make it the most of it. So please thank you so much, Candace and everyone at Forge, for this beautiful gift. And I'd like to thank my friend Jolene for joining me this first week to welcome me, and friendship and love. And it's really, really great to see y'all here. Thank you so much.
TSL, but the incredible team at Forge who helped make all this happen. So, thank you.